Hi, English 102 students. I'm going to begin our discussion and study of the theme for identity today with this article that's actually found in Psychology Today. Anytime we find something on the internet, we want to make sure that it comes from a reputable source, including the author. And it's written by a Dennis M. McClausen, PhD. And if we go down to the bottom of the article, we find out that he is a professor of American literature and screenwriting at the University of San Diego. So he's got the credentials there, and if we needed to know more, we could click on there, but that works for me. Talks about in this brief article, which is based on some of his broader research, that the search for identity is a major literary theme in American literature. The search for connected to an ancestral past, and we saw that in everyday use. You'll see the struggle that he talks about here in the poems that we look at today, but let's take a look here. He says, one of the most pervasive themes in American literature is the search for identity. Who are we? Where do we, you know, how do I identify myself? What makes me who I am? It says our earliest authors and writers celebrated literary characters who left that background behind, their heritage behind. They separated from family and ancestry and the past to head west. Initially, that's, you know, the Eastern Hemisphere. You've got Europe, you've got Africa, you've got the move west. Was they thought they were coming into the West Indies, right? And they ran into the Americas. But even once they got into the eastern side of America, they started to move west. It was a celebration of, primarily for most of those early colonists and immigrants, a severing of their European ties. We proclaimed our independence in 1776, said we're not British anymore. That's not who we are. We are Americans. And they were trying to create a national American identity that didn't have a king. Later, the westward movement and the explorers and the pioneers left their families behind in the colonies and pursued their dreams out west. And from there, we get the sort of cowboy identity or the pioneer identity for America. And that western cowboy identity still lingers today as uniquely American. R.W.B. Lewis, one prominent literary critic, he says, described this new cultural hero in his book, The American Adam, borrowing from the biblical Adam as the beginner, an individual emancipated from history. Now, freedom, emancipation, is a key identity and value in America. This person is freed from past history, bereft, not bothered by ancestry, untouched and undefiled by the usual inheritances of family and race. So back the system that they left behind in Europe, it was very set by that. Only the first, if there was anything to inherit, only the firstborn son inherited the title and the lands and the property. And the secondborn son, he had to find his own way. Maybe he joined the military or he joined the ministry. You could see that even play out today with Prince William and Prince Harry. Prince William, as the oldest, inherits all of the titles and royalty and the privilege, and he's going to be the next king. Prince Harry, you know, he stepped away. He took on this American identity of trying to stand alone, be self-reliant, self-propelling, and has had a lot of consequences, but he stood to gain very little. A little cottage house, a few titles. He found a career, you know, somewhat in the military, spent 10 years there. So a lot, you know, some of that hasn't changed. And it was that kind of locked in situation that propelled many, not just for religious freedom, but also for social freedom. Cooper's Leatherstocking character, famous old novel, Melville's Ishmael, Twain from Moby Dick, Twain's Huckleberry Finn, many others come from this cultural and historical background. Think about Finn leaving all of the people in town behind, going out on his river adventure with his friend alone, you know, Jim. Many others evolve from this cultural and historical background. So they have a few other examples there. But now we're seeing a shift. For some time, we've seen a different pattern emerging in our national consciousness. So for a while, it was the lone hero. You have sort of the, if you remember from your grandparents, like in John Wayne, or kind of the cowboy hero all alone. We don't know their background. We don't know where they came from. They've left it behind, be it a pioneer and go alone. That was a different pattern emerging. Studies have demonstrated that Americans, more than ever before, are researching their ancestral connections, their heritage, as they sense that our American national identity and values have changed a lot in our lifetime. They want, indeed, desperately need to be more grounded in the continuance of ancestral connections. Also, a lot of things are changing and are more very rapidly. So we see this in everyday use where Mama and Maggie are holding on to their ancestral connections by continuing to some of the same practices, quilting. But Dee, who is trying to move on to the modern changes and grasp the freedom and opportunity that the civil rights movement afford for her, and she still wants to be grounded in her ancestral connections too, but she just looks at it differently. She's changed her name to an African name, Wangero. She's trying to, she doesn't want Dee, anymore. And you see that struggle between, well, who's really honoring their ancestral connections, their heritage better. This deeply felt need appears to be reflected even more in children who have never successfully integrated into their adopted families. Maybe you connect with that. That's the, he mentions a novel here and makes a personal connection, which I ask you to do from time to time in your essays, like he does one. Like my father, who struggled in his adoptive home, Laura Field in the novel wants desperately to be more than just an individual standing alone, self-reliant, self-propelling, be more in community. And learn, she wants to learn the identities of those who made her life possible. So interesting place to be there with identity. And we're going to look first at a couple of Langston Hughes poems, talk about them a little bit, and then in the next little clip, we will look at some by Ashley Jones, and then a little excerpt from A Doll's House, so we get a variety here, in addition to everyday use. I'll be previewing essay one in another video, and that's where you'll be discussing the theme of identity, and you'll be drawing from these different poems. All right, let's go to I2. If you're not familiar with Langston Hughes, click on here. You'll see some things about him there to the right, and you'll want to become familiar with him. Significant African American writer, poet, novelist, fiction writer, playwright, and wrote during the 20s through the 60s. Major contributor to the Harlem Renaissance. His poem here, I2, is a response poem to Walt Whitman's poem, I Sing America. That's an identity. That was when Walt Whitman lived, when America was forging out its national identity. And so he talks about the blacksmith, Walt Whitman does, and all these common laborers that made up, that's what America was. We weren't royal, we didn't have royalty. We were, all the same. We were supposed to be equal, but we weren't, right? And so here, Langston Hughes talks about, hey, well, I'm an American too. He says, I too sing America. And that's a direct reference to Walt Whitman's poem. I am the darker brother. Whitman didn't talk about his darker brothers. He just talked about white America. I am the darker brother. They send me to eat in the kitchen when company comes. So even though he might be a part of the family, he might literally biologically be a part of the family, but because he's the darker brother, when company comes, he's sent to eat in the kitchen. Maybe you watched the movie The Help. You can get a sense of that there. But I laugh and I eat well and I grow strong. I have it okay, but I'm still not considered and identified as part of the family in public. Tomorrow, though, he sees change coming. I'll be at the table when company comes. And nobody'll dare say to me, eat in the kitchen then. There'll be a day when I'm identified as full member of the family, as fully American. Besides, he says they'll see how beautiful I am and be ashamed. I too am America. So he's integrating himself into an American national identity. He's trying to diversify it. And by saying I too am an American. His other poem is similar. But it's a next step in that identity. when he writes I too, he's still the outsider, right? Looking in, still not fully accepted, not considered part of the group, right? I won't put it on here, but if you want to hear him read his poem Dinner Guest Me, there's the YouTube link there. I'm gonna click this to find that poem. Dinner guest, me. So he's the guest at dinner. He's not sent to the kitchen anymore, and he's not merely just sitting at the table. He's the guest. He's the guest of honor. But he still knows his identity is problematic. He says, I know I am the Negro problem. There's his first identification. Being wined and dined, okay, now he's the guest of honor, though. It's different from the previous one. I'm wined and dined, answering the usual questions that come to the white mind, which seeks demurely, politely, and to probe in polite way the why and where with all of darkness, USA. So it's an acceptance that the African American is part of the American identity, but it's unknown. It's to the white mind. It's foreign. It's been pushed away and excluded and separated. And now it's like you're here and you're a part of it, but I don't really know who you are. So I am wining and dining you. You're the guest of honor, but I really am inquiring. I don't really know who you are. Wondering how things got this way in the current Democratic night, murmuring gently over Frase Du Bois. We need to look that up. But the Du Bois reminds me of W.E. Du Bois, who was a famous African American scholar and writer. But this also could be, so it might have more than one connotation. So let's take a look. Frase Du Bois. Du Bois is strawberries. Okay, but just does not go unnoticed to me that Du Bois is also W.E. Du Bois. And then the murmur gently is, I'm so ashamed of being white. So there's this identity dilemma for the white individuals who are owning their whiteness and also owning what that means in terms of what they've done in the past or what they're associated with. The lobster is delicious, the wine divine, and the center of attention at the damask table. Mine, I'm the center of attention. They are wining and dining. They give me the best kind of high class dinner, lobster and wine, and this beautiful tablecloth out of damask, and all the center of attention's on me. So this is he's identifying himself differently now than he was in the previous one. Some changes, but he still says, "I know I am the Negro problem." And he picks that up at the end. To be a problem on Park Avenue at 8 is not so bad. Solutions to the problem, of course, wait. Park Avenue, if you've played Monopoly, you know that that is a reference to New York City and a pretty high class section and road where high class shops are there. So he should have access now, but they don't know quite. And he has the money to shop there, but they don't know quite how to receive him. And he talks about that change in the identity, but still the problematic identity. There's a whole background, a little bit more here about him and his ancestry. He's the great great grandson of Charles Henry Langston, brother of John Mercer Langston, the first Black American to be elected to public office. He lived just long enough, 1967, to see the civil rights movement and the changes that were coming up to that, and see that shift in identity from sort of Reconstruction South, even though he didn't live in the South, he lived in Missouri out west, to 1967. So those two there, I'm about out of time for those two. These are in 15-minute little segments. So those are two poems that you can choose to discuss along with maybe everyday use. But we have some more that we'll do in the next video.